Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new here. My name is Emily and I make a lot of videos about Salesforce. Today we're going to be talking about Salesforce. We are going to be doing another salary review. Last week we did one about the administrator salaries within 2022. Now let's talk about developer salaries. I think this will be really fun. I have very similar resources as I did last time. It is going to be the Salesforce Ben salary review, link down below, as well as the Salesforce career path page where they post salary information. I've looked at a lot of different salaries on job postings, job listings with recruiters, chatted with them, and so I kind of want to talk about what I think is high, what I think is low, if these are accurate, what you can do to increase your salary, and different factors that will play into this. So let's go ahead and talk about different factors before we jump into the actual salaries. There are a lot of different factors that will contribute to your salary. This will be cost of living where you are. Again, this will be mainly geared toward the United States because that is where I live, where I'm familiar with, and where a lot of companies are based that use Salesforce. So that is going to be the number one, I think, driving factor is your location for salary. Other things that could be factors for you are going to be certifications, the number of certifications that you have, the types of certifications that you have. If you're a developer who also understands communities, then that's going to be a bump in salary if you are working on communities, as well as maybe you are a CPQ developer. That could be a salary increase there for you. Other things that might increase your salary are going to be other certifications or other experience that you might have. This will be different degrees that you might have, developer certifications. Maybe you are familiar with Capato and you have Capato certifications. That'll help you as well. And finally, it's gonna be experience. I don't necessarily look at experience as a number of years that you have developing on the platform. I tend to view experience as the number of different solutions that you are able to solve. So let's say you have been a developer for 3-4 years, that might qualify you as a mid-level developer. However, if you develop this really cool AppExchange product that is really well loved and well liked by the community, then you could see yourself going into a senior developer position. That is my general overview of different factors that will contribute to your salary. Let's go ahead and jump into the salaries on Salesforce Ben's website. The first one is going to be entry-level developers within the United States is $113,000. Personally, I think this is about accurate. For an entry-level developer. It'd be really helpful if you do have some development experience. Possibly you studied in college or you were an admin before and you are going into a developer role. Personally, I think that former admins, now developers, are a really helpful thing to have as a developer because you understand the platform on the basic quote-unquote on a foundational level, and you understand the different lines that can be drawn between clicks versus code and what needs to be coded versus really what can be done in configuration, because it's a lot easier for a company to change configuration rather than to change code. Someone who can say we don't need to develop this solution, this can be configured, is a very valuable asset. So I think the salary is justified. If you were an admin before and possibly a senior admin before, you might see your salary higher than this. For a senior level developer on the Salesforce platform in the United States, it's going to be around $150,000. I feel like I could see more. I feel like senior level positions that I've seen could go up to 170, depending on experience, depending on certifications, of course. I think that this is average-ish. Okay, let's hop on to Salesforce's website now and take a look there. This one is lower than I thought. This is saying the average US salary for a developer is $108,000. That's really low, and I personally think that's more of an entry-level developer salary, personally. I think developers are very, very useful and they are very, very needed on the Salesforce platform, and so they should be compensated more than that. Other statistics that I do see here, they say by the end of 2024, we'll see 4.2 million new jobs added to the Salesforce ecosystem. This is really, really great, and a lot of them are going to be developer positions, but not all of them. I think that the admin salary is growing more than, or excuse me, the admin jobs are growing at a faster rate than the developer jobs, and Salesforce is working really, really hard to create more configuration tools to help reduce the need for developers and increase access to Salesforce to people who maybe don't want to learn code or who really struggle to understand and learn code, me personally. A lot of their data that is on their website is from 2018 on Salesforce's website, is from 2018, which was 4 years ago. If this was a 4 year ago salary, I would maybe believe it. I would probably believe it, that was the average. The annual growth rate for the developer market for Salesforce is 206% averaged out from the last 5 years. So it is growing at half the rate that the admin jobs are, which still means like 206% is still a lot of new jobs, but the developer market is growing at a slower rate than the admin positions. So if you were considering going one way versus the other, then I would definitely start out on admin before exploring other avenues, possibly developer or architect. Both are fantastic options as you grow your mastery of the Salesforce ecosystem. So thank you so much for joining me. I hope that you found this useful, this discussion on different factors that play into salaries, and different salaries that you might see as a developer on the Salesforce platform. So if you have any questions for me, leave them down below and I will try and get back to you as fast as possible. Like, subscribe. I post videos here around 3 times a week, at least I'm trying to. So thank you so much for joining me, and I'll catch you in the next one.